My name is Dr. Ricky Dhaliwal. I am an emergency medicine physician here at Sky Ridge, where I am the assistant medical director. And today I'd like to talk to you about frostbite, as it is something that affects many Coloradoans and folks visiting Colorado every year. One of the questions I get asked regularly is, what is frostbite? It's pretty simple. It is freezing of your skin, which also freezes the soft tissue below your skin and then causes the effects that we see. The initial symptoms that you see are red and cold skin, which is then followed by pale and hard skin with loss of sensation. Those signs and symptoms usually happen to areas of your body that are most exposed to cold. Well, frostbite can be very serious. The places that it affects most commonly are your hands, nose, feet, all the extremities, chin as well. And what can end up happening is long-term effects, which are things like numbness and tingling, worsening injury in the future, and sometimes actually amputation can result in this because of the severe injury that occurs. So it is a very dangerous issue that if not dealt with initially and immediately can cause long-term implications. What are the things that cause frostbite? Well, the answer on this is cold, whether that be exposure to cold or touching things that are cold. The biggest issue is prolonged exposure to these things, even after symptoms occur. And the problem that we see here, especially in Colorado, is that you may not notice that you are having frostbite symptoms, even though you are in a prolonged state of cold exposure, because one of your initial symptoms is numbness and tingling and loss of sensation. So it's something that can happen quite regularly here in Colorado. And when it does happen, you may not notice initially. One of the questions we also get is, what is frostnip? Frostnip is a milder version of frostbite where it is more on the superficial tissue that gets affected. You may see some redness or paleness overlying the skin, but none of the other sequelae that we notice with frostbite. With this, that's something that can be treated at home and making sure that you remove yourself from the cold exposure. So the things you can do to protect yourself from frostbite are dressing appropriately. So when it's cold outside, make sure that you are well dressed in terms of winter weather. You have your extremities covered, whether that be your hands with gloves, your feet with boots, or your face with a face mask. All of these things can decrease the risk of you having frostbite occur to one of your body parts. One of the questions that I get asked is, what do you do if you think you do have frostbite? I think the first thing is to get yourself out of the environmental exposure that may be causing the frostbite. So get yourself out of the cold. Once you're in a place that's warmer, remove all your clothing so that way you have no wet or cold clothing touching your body. And then the next step is not to go and put your hand in a fireplace or put your hand over a warm stove. Instead, it's really important that you warm your extremities or the areas that you're concerned about consistently for 30 minutes in a warm water bath that's at least 37 degrees to 40 degrees in temperature. And you wanna make sure that you do this for at least 30 minutes. The reason being that if you actually start warming or thawing your extremity and then stop it and it becomes frozen again, that causes even worse an injury. One of the questions also is, when do I need to go get emergency medical care for frostbite? I would say that if there is any concern for frostbite, you should be evaluated by some provider. If it's more serious, where you have blistering, severe discoloration, or a larger area affected, you need to be seen in the emergency department immediately. If you are going to do that, I would recommend not rewarming unless you're able to rewarm for at least 30 minutes prior to arrival. Because if you rewarm and then it freezes again, that causes worsening injury. So then what do we do in the emergency department if you do have frostbite? Well, what we do is a few things. The first is we start the rewarming process and we ensure that we rewarm for at least 30 minutes. So that's water temperature at 37 to 40 degrees Celsius. And then with that, we also do a very complete exam, not only before we start the rewarming process, but also after, because what you'll see is that some injuries you'll start noticing after the rewarming occurs. Then if it is extensive and we are concerned about what we call necrosis, which is dying of the tissue, we may end up doing scans, which allow us to assess for how well the blood flow is going into your extremities. And sometimes, if necessary, we do instill thrombolytic blood clot busting medications, which help to get flow back to those extremities. For some extreme circumstances, we may send you to a hyperbaric chamber, which we do have here at Sky Ridge, because we have found that the hyperbaric chamber may improve long-term outcomes from frostbite type injuries. We see many cases of frostbite in Colorado every year. One of the most important things is prevention, because that can avoid us even having to deal with the problem in the first place.